A very warm welcome. You're watching the news with me, Anubhuti Gaur. Let's take a look at what's making headlines. Union Home Minister Amit Shah has reaffirmed that J&K would get statehood back once the conditions are favourable. Won't remain a union territory forever. Shah has also said that the notion that only Article 370 protected Kashmiri identity and culture is a wrong one, as all the regional identities are protected by the Indian Constitution. He also called the misuse of Article 370 as the root cause of terrorism in J&K. While reacting to the controversy over Rahul's foreign visit, Congress says respect personal liberty. This as the BJP has been attacking Rahul Gandhi and raised several questions over reports of his visit abroad at a time when the two key states, Maharashtra and Haryana, are going to polls on October 21st. A major milestone in the government's fight against black money stashed abroad. India gets first chunk of Swiss bank account details of its nationals under a new automatic information exchange pact. India is among the 75 countries with which Switzerland's Federal Tax Administration has exchanged information on financial accounts within the framework of the global standards of automatic exchange of information. The next exchange would take place in September 2020. As the Supreme Court stays felling of forest trees till October 21st, the Mumbai Metro Rail Corporation Limited has cut down 2141 trees in the RA colony between Friday and Saturday, says it has already cut down the trees it needed for its plan to clear 33 hectares of RA land for the construction of a car shed and depot. The construction of the buildings would continue as planned. After backing the felling of RA forest trees, Union Environment Minister Prakash Javdekar gave a cautious response on the RA issue, refused to answer any questions on the cutting of RA forest trees. Javdekar also said, and I quote, "I'm not taking any question on RA today because the Supreme Court has given an order and the policy and the practice is if you fell one tree, you plant and ensure the growth of five trees. Remember, the Supreme Court ordered today that no more trees should be cut till October 21st. A Mumbai beggar dies a millionaire with assets over Rs 10 lakhs. Documents for the fixed deposits worth Rs 8 lakhs with several banks and at least Rs 1.5 lakh in coins were found. He lived alone in the house at a slum in southeast Mumbai's Gowandi. He left behind a voter identity card, PAN card and Aadhaar card. US President Donald Trump justifies decision to withdraw US troops from Turkey's border with Syria, says the region would have to figure out the situation and that US needed to get out of the ridiculous endless wars. Meanwhile, Turkish President Erdogan has said that his army was ready to launch operations against the Kurdish militants in Syria at any moment. Following the US announcement that it would not stand in the way, he said that we can come any night without warning. It is absolutely out of question for further toleration of threats from terrorist groups. That's all in this edition of the Bulletin. The news and updates will continue on the other side.